This day and age, we're running around from place to place, we're hopping in cars, we're jumping on planes, we're traveling all over the place. It's like we never get to be in one place for an extended period of time, which makes it really hard to get really wholesome food. Because honestly, we don't always have time to be preparing nice, voluptuous green salads. I wish that was the case, but the reality is it just can't always happen. So it's important that we start paying attention to what we can extrapolate from those big healthy salads to be able to get in a more convenient form so we still actually get the nutrients we need. And it doesn't have to be this super complex thing. If we know the basics, we can get ourselves ahead of the curve and still be healthy no matter what the case. I'm Thomas Delauer with Antler Farms, and we're going to talk a little bit today about organic greens. And we're going to talk about some of the things and the components of organic greens that play a big role when it comes down to feeling and looking great. The first thing you want to talk about is chlorophyll. Okay, when you talk about deep leafy greens, that deep dark green color, we're talking about chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is what gives it that pigment. Chlorophyll is what really gives it what we need out of it. So when you're talking about algae-based things, when you're talking about deep leafy greens, deep dark leafy greens, we're talking about chlorophyll. So chlorophyll is essentially the blood of plants. I know that sounds weird, but chlorophyll is very similar to hemin, to basically the human blood. Human blood is bound to iron, whereas chlorophyll is bound to magnesium. So slightly different, it's only one simple mineral off. So although it sounds crazy to think that plants have blood, chlorophyll really is that blood. So it plays a big role. So by default, it helps replenish red blood cells really, really well. So when it comes down to being able to deliver oxygen and have a lot of energy, we want to be able to get more red blood cells. That's all there is to it. That's why athletes train at altitude, because they try to get more red blood cells. Quite honestly, that's why athletes do things that maybe they shouldn't be doing, like blood doping and stuff like that. They're adding more red blood cells. Well, what if you can get more red blood cells simply by consuming chlorophyll? That's the kind of thing we really want to be paying attention to. But chlorophyll also has a unique ability to chelate heavy metals. A lot of the sluggishness that we experience in daily life is a result of having heavy metals like iron and things like that in our body, even lead to some degree. These heavy metals, these iron, these leads, these mercuries, things like that, they can be really, really bad for our guts. They can be not just bad for our guts, but bad for our entire body and immune system. So when we have the ability to chelate these excess heavy metals, it allows the body to process them and then therefore allows us to excrete them and therefore process nutrients better, which therefore just helps us feel better in general. Additionally, chlorophyll is very powerful at providing the body with sulfur. Now, sulfur sounds like a bad thing. It sounds like just, you know, that rotten egg kind of smell that you don't want to consume or anything like that. But sulfur is critical to the production of glutathione. Without glutathione, we can't actually neutralize a lot of the free radicals in our bodies, which means we'd become overrun with toxins. So sulfur, being a precursor to that glutathione, is very, very important. Now, another thing I want to talk about is spirulina. See, spirulina gets a bad rap because normally spirulina is just kind of thrown under the bus as like this simple commodity algae. The fact is, when you get true good quality spirulina, you're getting a really cool, what's called cyanobacterium. You see, cyanobacterium is the algae form of like a greens that we would normally get in a salad or anything like that. Cyanobacterium means it's like that concentrated algae form. Now, when we talk about spirulina specifically, we're talking 60 to 70% complete protein. It literally is the most protein-dense food on the planet. You're just usually not having a whole lot of it. It's extremely complete and very protein-dense, so you're not only getting a lot of the amino acids that you need, but you're getting just a full spectrum of nutrients in general. Additionally, if you ever look at spirulina close up, you notice it has a slightly blue tint. Well, this is from something known as a phycocyanin. The phycocyanins are literally what give it the blue pigment. So what that blue pigment does is it provides a very powerful antioxidant effect, but a very powerful anti-inflammatory effect. Been shown to modulate a lot of inflammatory markers within the body, but quite honestly, it's just the overall meat and heart of spirulina. It's what separates it from everything else. It's literally the only thing on the planet that would actually have phycocyanins in a natural form. Otherwise, you'd have to get it in some synthetic form. So that blue tint that makes spirulina so unique truly is unique on all counts, even inside your body. Next up, we want to talk about chlorella. You see, chlorella is a single cell algae, very unique in that it is a single cell algae, but it also makes it so it's very easy for your body to process. So in a way, it's a living organism. So when you consume chlorella, you're not just getting the benefits of it being a green, you're getting the benefits of it actually being a life form that can have a very powerful effect on your body. Studies have shown that it powerfully modulates nuclear factor kappa B, which is a master inflammatory regulator within your body. So something we definitely want to be controlling. So when we can have chlorella in the mix and take control of that, obviously we can feel a lot better, have a lot less water retention, just overall optimize ourselves. But then we also find that chlorella increases what's called phase two detoxification within the liver. We have three different phases of detoxing in the liver. And phase two is where you take fat-soluble toxins, which most toxins are stored in the fat, and break them down into a water-soluble form so the body can excrete them. Without chlorella, it's very difficult for the liver to do that. So this phase two detoxification is critical, and when we can support that, we can convert more of the fat-based toxins that are stored in our body into a water-soluble form so that we can actually process and excrete them through the liver and kidneys. Additionally, to make matters even better, when we look at chlorella, we actually find that there's a high degree of gamma-aminobutyric acid. GABA is what helps you feel good. It helps balance out the glutamate levels. So if you're suffering from anxiety or anything like that, you might find that taking some chlorella may just help calm your nerves a little bit. So when it comes down to living optimized, you need to take control of your health. And sometimes a big salad won't cut it. So I encourage you to check out Antler Farms Organic Greens and make sure that you're always doing your own due diligence when it comes down to your health.